Did you see this news from a few weeks back? Google's CEO says that YouTube Shorts content in the US now earns more revenue per watch hour than long-form content. So if you're making that same old three-hour podcast and not generating clips from it, or your boring old me creating 20, 30-minute tutorials on software and not doing Shorts, you're definitely missing a huge chunk of revenue. Lucky for us LTD addicts, it's Black Friday time and AppSumo is bringing back Reap. Yes, despite what you see here, it's no longer sold out. If this video is published, Reap is available on AppSumo right now. And this is one of the best LTDs for repurposing long-form content and creating Shorts with ease. It's kind of hard to believe that it's already Black Friday season again, but AppSumo's drop number one is currently available. It's full of audio and visual tools, so go ahead and check those out. I've got a link down below in the description, but today I'm talking specifically about Reap. By the way, if you do want to keep up with all of the AppSumo Black Friday deals, definitely get subscribed to this channel. I've got big plans this Black Friday, as I typically do. If you are lucky enough to have grabbed Reap the first time it was on AppSumo, you'll be happy to know there are additional tiers available. You can now go all the way up to tier 5, which is going to give you 1,800 minutes of video processing. Let me get my handy dandy abacus out here. 1,800 divided by 60, that's 30 hours of video clipping. That is a ton. Okay, so throughout the rest of this video, I'm gonna show you all of the tools in Reap. It does more than just generate clips. You can also add captions, edit videos, reframe, and even dub into other languages. I'll show you how all of that works. But first, you do need to know that this video is sponsored by AppSumo. All right, let's get right into the review here. The first option is to generate clips. This is the main event. This is what most people will come to Reap for. It's very easy to use this tool. You simply paste in your YouTube link and then hit get clips, and you're going to see a ton of options. Oh, I should mention that you can just upload your file here as well if you don't have it published on YouTube. Now, I've already gone ahead and generated my clips, but I want to show you the features here. So I just pasted in the same YouTube URL that I used to generate my clips. And essentially, we're going to go to the screen where we can choose our settings. So first, we choose our video genre. Is this a talking video, a presentation, or a gaming video? I think this is a really cool option because I know for my content where I'm typically in a little bubble in the corner of the window, and then everything's kind of going on the screen, but there's not a clear focus point for AI. It tends to fail. These types of tools don't do so good with my content. So I'm gonna show you how this one did in a little bit. Just know it's a difficult task, right? So it's really nice they have these options to do presentation or gaming. It's gonna be a lot more appropriate for certain types of content. I'm gonna choose gaming this time around. And then we choose our language. There are a lot of languages available. You can see you just keep on scrolling. Essentially, all of the languages on planet Earth seem to be available here. In the options for translation, your only real option here is to translate into English. There is another part of the tool that lets you dub into other languages, but essentially, if you're coming from Spanish, you could then translate to English, but it does not work inside of this part of the tool to go from, let's say, English to Spanish in that direction. Then we can set our aspect ratio. 9:16 is going to be the typical aspect ratio for things like YouTube Shorts. And then we can set our resolution all the way up to 4K. Now this is limited based on what plan you purchase. It looks like you have to get to about tier 3. I'm just dealing with the existing AppSumo page right now. And interestingly, tier 2 is nowhere to be found. So I'm not sure if it was tier 2 or tier 3 that adds in 4K support, but just know you'll want to check those plans when they are available, which is right now, but that's the future. So I'm gonna do 4K for this because it's a 4K video. And then I've got my caption presets here. So really nice to give you some visual examples. We've got deep dive, popping, beastie, YC. You can keep scrolling. There's quite a few different options for your captions. Note, you can change this after the fact. So if you're not really certain, just go ahead and pick one and you can edit it from there. You can also create your own preset for captions. So if you wanted to go into the preset editor here, essentially you'll just have a blank screen. It'd be nice maybe if they gave you some text to actually create the preset, but you set up your fonts, you set up your colors, you set up your shadows and strokes, you know, the outline of the actual text to make sure that it's going to look the way you want. And then you can position it somewhere on the screen. Here it's in the bottom 70%. And then we can choose an animation, you know, for how it changes between the actual words, and then the caption animation itself as well. So there's options for everything here. You can set it up once when you're happy with it, then it's going to be a preset you can easily apply to your video. So there's even more presets right here if you really want to pick something that's done for you and just not think. There's a lot of options. And then towards the end, it gets real simple here. You just choose the time frame for where the clips are. By default, it's going to grab your entire video. But if you know, oh, I want to get clips only from the second half, you can just use these little sliders to find the right time. Then you set the length of the clips that you like. I'm going to go 30 seconds to 60 seconds in that range. You can go all the way up to 3-minute clips here. And this is a really cool feature. If you have a specific topic that you want it to make clips about, you can simply type in the relevant content here. It's going to look for that inside of the transcript and then try to create clips around that topic. So that's a really cool feature. And when you have everything the way you want it, just go ahead and hit get clips. It's going to take a bit to process, roughly 15 minutes or so. They have sped things up. You can see in the updates here, they are working at faster processing speed, faster clipping, better progress. So they're definitely making some improvements to this platform. If you tried it out before and you found it to be a little bit slow, definitely give it another look because I found it to be very, very speedy. Here are the clips that actually created from my video. It gave me 19 clips from this 27-minute video. There is no way to define how many clips you'd like, so just keep that in mind. You're going to get a whole bunch, and then you can kind of pick and choose from there. There are some pretty good editing features here as well. So let's say I opened up this one right here. I hit edit. And now I'm inside of their editor. This is the same interface we will see later on when we do dedicated editing inside of the tool. But kind of nice here, we get our transcript over here to the left. And let's say I didn't like a line here. I can easily just select some words. Let's go maybe these words right here. Just hold down shift and click, and then I can just remove that from the video, and then boom, it's gone. Of course, there is an undo. You can easily add it back in if you make a mistake. Now, when I created these clips, I did ask the AI to look for any mentions of the EPUB file that I download. So here's a great example of that feature I mentioned at the end of creating the clips. It actually did it. It found a clip where I've said I downloaded the EPUB file. So it was able to find that kind of specific detail and pull it right out. Now, as far as the flow of the clip, you can see here the sentence just kind of ends with which on my Mac opens up inside of, and then we don't have anything else. Now you can actually add additional segments. So if I wanted to be in the Books app, I just select that, add the segment, and now my clip actually finishes more completely. That was a complaint I saw in some of the early AppSumo reviews. I'm happy to say that it has been fixed in quite a very easy to understand manner. If the captions are wrong, like it gets a word incorrect, you can just select the word and then go ahead and hit correct word here. You'll be able to type and add whatever you like. So maybe I'd like this to be spelled EPUB like that for whatever reason. You can do that. Now, with my captions, it's all in capital letters, so that doesn't really matter. Let's transition to talk about editing these captions. So let's say I wanted to edit the captions, maybe even do something like move them to a different part of the screen. I can easily just drag and drop them wherever I like. Just make sure you've got the captions lane here selected so that you're moving the correct file. You can move around your video, right? So I mentioned before how difficult making shorts out of my content is because I'm recording an entire screen. Well, if I've got it selected, I can actually position it wherever I want. So maybe I want to show myself, and then later on I want to show a different part of the screen. Well, I can easily reframe things. I'll just select maybe right here. I want to make a reframe. I can select right here and then go ahead and split the video. And then this chunk right here, I can move to a different part of the screen. So let's say I wanted to show this part of the UI. I can even zoom out and show the whole screen by changing from fit to fill. And then it shows the entire screen here, but it keeps the aspect ratio nice. It actually has blurred the background, expanded that, and blurred it out to obviously fill up the whole screen. That looks pretty good. And now I can move my captions down here. Jumping back to captions for a minute, as I mentioned before, you can easily change your preset after the fact. So if I've decided, you know, these captions really aren't working in this video, I simply select the captions and then go over here to my presets, and I can choose any of the same presets that were available in the initial clip creation process. And if you don't want captions, you can of course just turn them off altogether. It's also really easy to add some B-roll to your clips. So if you've got a long form content, it's just two people talking, that might be great for your podcast. But if you're competing on a shorts platform where, you know, people's attention is a lot smaller, you might need to spruce things up with a little bit of B-roll. We've got some stock media built in, as well as the ability to upload your own images, video, and audio to supplement what people are saying on the screen. I'll give you an example here with the B-roll. Let's say I searched for reading. I'm talking about books here, and I wanted to grab this B-roll. I just click on it once, it drops it right into the editor. I can move things around so it appears at the correct point in the video. And of course, reframe it very easily and even stretch it out so that it fills up the right part of the screen. There, that looks better. She's actually reading. So that's the editor, very easy to get around, intuitive if you've used other video editing applications. I don't think you'll struggle with this at all. It's not sluggish, it's not slow, very reactive, feels almost like it's on the desktop. You'll notice that the quality here is maybe not as high quality, like, you know, that is definitely not as high quality as the original video, but that's because it hasn't been exported yet. So just go ahead and save things, then choose export. It's going to be a lot higher quality on the output. Basically, it's just compressing things so that when you're using the editor, it's speedy and snappy. And then when you go to export things, it renders at full quality. There is, of course, a bit of a delay when you do that. So now it's back to processing this clip, and I'll only be able to download it after the render is complete. All right, so now let's tackle some of the other tools here. We've got captions, edit videos, auto reframe, and AI dubbing. These are all subsets of that main tool. So let's say you already created your short and you just want to add the captions. Well, all of the features are going to be available that you just saw when it generated the clips, except it's not generating clips this time. It's working with whatever you feed it. So you simply drag and drop your file in here. You can't link up to social media to download it. You have to actually supply your own file, you drop it in, and then you can set up your captions to be whatever you like. Of course, the language options are the same as before as well. The same principle applies to the AI video editor here, except you can add in your YouTube link to work from that, or you can simply drop your file in here. Maximum file size is 2 gigabytes, and the max resolution for editing is 1080p, so no 4K here. I recorded a short monologue that I was reading off of a teleprompter for the very first time here, made tons of mistakes, and here it is inside of the editor. So you can see it is 16:9, it's not 9:16. It actually points out where there's longer gaps. This is typically where I made a mistake because I paused for a half second to reread the sentence. So I said, I don't feel like Bernard. I don't feel like Bernard again. So, and then I said it a third time. So I think what I wanted to do is start right here and then go up to right about there and remove that from the video. This is a very fast and simple way to edit a video. I like it a lot in principle. There's a few areas where it could definitely be improved, like if it broke up each statement into its own line, it would be easier to edit. And also, if it noticed repeats, maybe it would select the last repeat by default. I don't expect the AI to necessarily understand which take is the best right now, although that would be awesome. If it just saw duplicates where I say the same thing over and over again, you might assume that that is multiple takes of the same line, and it right now it just really doesn't do that. I kind of have to read through the entire thing to look for any of those mistakes. But otherwise, the editor is exactly the same. I can even add B-roll in here. I can add captions. Everything is available. Let's talk about the auto reframe tool. Again, you're just dropping your file in here and it's going to change the aspect ratio for you. I've got one right here. This is the reframe. There's these tags to help you know what your project focus was. This is the exact same video I just showed you, but now it is reframed to 9:16 from 16:9. So I can open this up and adjust it if I want to, but it looks like it did a pretty good job of focusing on my face in the center of the frame. So I'm happy with that. Yeah, just kind of scrolling through here. I don't move around a lot. So if it's in a good position, it's basically going to be good for the whole video. I guess you'd have to test this on content that is shifting around a bit more to see if it can handle action. I think it probably will just do best with talking head style videos, not necessarily like running around the world vlogging type of videos. And the last feature that's currently available, because as you probably have noticed, transcription, eye correction, and noise removal are all marked as coming soon. Transcription would be what it sounds like, just transcripts. That should be something they can do pretty quickly since they're already doing captions. Eye correction is a cool idea. Fix the gaze so someone is locking eyes with you on the camera rather than, say, reading their screen. And then finally, noise removal to clean up bad audio, obviously. So in terms of the AI dubbing, you simply drop your video in here. You can't grab a video from YouTube. You have to have the file on your computer, and then you can choose the language where it started. And there's a lot of options here, like we saw before. And now we finally have the same number of options to translate to. Then you simply click translate and off you go. It starts chewing on your video and you get a translated version. Here, I translated my video from English into Japanese. How do I sound?
僕の名前がバーナードが問題だ。 誰が名前を決めたんだろう。僕が自分で名前を決めたのか。バーナードって感じがしない。
So you do get a dubbed video, but there are no voice options. You're just given what you're given. And there's certainly nothing like voice cloning where they're taking my original voice and then making me sound like I know how to speak Japanese. I should point out that under AI tools, there appear to be some options for the AI voiceover. But when I click on this, it just says loading model and then gives me an error. So perhaps these features are coming, but they're not currently working for me at the time of recording. There, you can see the error. It's something about the TPS reports. All right, there is one more major feature to this tool, and that is social media scheduling. So first, you can go ahead and connect up your social media accounts. We've got YouTube, TikTok, and Instagram that you can connect up, and then you can actually schedule your videos directly from the Reap platform. You get a content calendar here. You go ahead and add in your post, choose the platform you'd like to publish on, and off you go. It's not a full-featured social media scheduler. You can't necessarily just do posts to Facebook and announce your new video on YouTube, but it is certainly better than nothing. I do want to mention that you can collaborate on this platform if you get a higher tier AppSumo plan. Simply click on your studio name here, choose invite members. You can also get to this screen inside of settings and just go ahead and add in your member right here, choose invite. There's only one permission level. It says when you add members, you grant them the ability to edit, create, and share projects within this workspace. A project, by the way, is not a group of videos. It's a single video that is considered a project. So if you wanted to use this as an agency for multiple clients, that would not work so well. You'd have to get an account for each user that you wanted to service, because otherwise everybody who you added could see each other's videos. Just looking at this AppSumo deal page one more time, it looks like the advanced AI tools are limited to above tier one, possibly tier three. Like I mentioned, tier two is missing here for some reason. They do mention voice clone dubbing. So I don't know if that's a feature that is coming later, but in addition to that, they mentioned background noise removal, which is also a coming soon feature that will be available for the higher tiers as well. So that is Reap on AppSumo. Very impressed with this tool. It's speedy, it's high quality. I think the only way they could make it better is to turn it into a desktop application. I would absolutely be there for that. I'm gonna go ahead and give this one an 8.7 out of 10. I definitely recommend it if you need to repurpose long form content. All right, so remember that Reap is part of AppSumo's day one drop. There's gonna be more drops to come, but very important, the price of Reap and all of the tools will be increasing over time. The best time to grab it is right now while it's still available and at the lowest price. Well, hopefully, depending on when you watch this, at the lowest price possible. After 7 days, the tiers are going to increase anywhere from about 10 to 15% in cost. So you can definitely save a serious chunk of money, especially if you're buying one of the tier four or tier five plans, which get a little bit spendy. If you want to get my feedback about one tool compared to another, or even just which tier would be best for your use case, definitely hit me up in the comments. I will try to help out as many people as possible. I've got my AppSumo link if you want to help support me, so click on that. And thanks to AppSumo again for sponsoring today's video. Like the video if you liked it. Subscribe if you want more Black Friday deals. We got a ton of content coming up over the next few weeks. My name is Dave Swift. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next review.